Dear students, this is Hiba Badawi. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In this part of the chapter, we'll be talking about solving exercises related to stoichiometry and dilution and calculating the molar mass of a hydrated salt. For this session, I want you to prepare your pen and your chemistry booklet. We will start by application 1, page 9. Let's read the question together. 10 grams of calcium carbonate are allowed to react with 100 milliliter hydrochloric acid of molarity or molar concentration 0.1 mol per liter, given the molar mass in gram per mole of calcium 14, carbon 12, and oxygen 16. Question number 1 says, write the equation of this chemical reaction. So the reactants are calcium carbonate, hydrochloric acid, and the products are 2CaCl2 plus CO2 plus H2O. We balance the reaction. Remember that carbonates, when they react with acids, they produce CO2. Secondly, question says, find the mass of the reactant in excess. To find the mass of the reactant in excess, we have to first determine the stoichiometric ratios and identify the limiting and excess reactant. Number of moles of CaCO3, the first reactant, is mass divided by molar mass. Why did we choose the mass? Because as you see here, the mass of calcium carbonate is given. So we will choose this number or this way to calculate the number of moles. And after we find the molar mass, we obtain the number of moles is 0.1 mole. For the second reactant, which is HCl, we are given its volume and its molarity. So number of moles of HCl is C times V. It's equal to 10 power minus 2 mol per liter. But remember that we are given the volume in milliliter. Convert it to liter by multiplying by 10 power minus 3. Now that we have calculated the number of moles of each reactant, we have to find the stoichiometric ratios. The ratio of CaCO3 is its number of moles divided by the coefficient 1. And the ratio of HCl is its number of moles divided by its coefficient 2. As you observe here, we have two different ratios. So the ratio of HCl is less than that of CaCO3. We conclude that HCl is a limiting reactant. Therefore, CaCO3 is the substance in excess. Now, to determine the mass, you should always find the number of moles, then convert it to mass. According to stoichiometric ratios, the number of moles of HCl, which is the limiting reactant, is equal to the number of moles of CaCO3 reacted. Then we find the number of moles of CaCO3 to be 0.005 mol. Now, this is the number of moles reactant. To find that remaining, we have to use the rule, which says that number of moles excess or remaining is equal to that initial minus reacted, which is 0.095 mol. Now, this number of moles, change it into mass. By multiplying by its molar mass, you obtain 9.5 gram. Question number 3. Calculate the volume of the gas liberated at STP. If we recall the reaction, the gas liberated is CO2. To calculate the volume of the gas, again, we should first calculate its number of moles. HCl is the limiting reactant, then according to stoichiometric ratio, number of moles of HCl initial over 2 is equal to number of moles of CO2 produced over 1. So, substitute the values and recall that number of moles of CO2 at any time of standard conditions or STP conditions is V divided by V molar. So we do the calculation and we obtain that V volume of CO2 is 0.112 liter or 120 milliliters. Let's start now with application 3 on page 10. 2 moles of an alkane CnH2n+2 are burned in the presence of oxygen gas, excess oxygen gas, to give 2 moles of carbon dioxide and 4 moles of water vapor. The question says, write the balance equation of the chemical reaction as a function of N. So the alkane reacts with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water vapor. The equation of the reaction is, in terms of N, balanced. Now, question 2 says, determine the molecular formula of this alkane. You are given the molar mass of carbon and hydrogen in gram per mole. As we know here that the alkane is limiting since oxygen is present in excess, and the number of moles of each product is also given. So if we get use of the stoichiometric ratio, according to stoichiometric ratio, the number of moles of the alkane initial over its coefficient 1 is equal to number of moles of the product CO2 divided by its coefficient n. Substitute the values of the number of moles given of the alkane and that of carbon dioxide, you obtain that N is equal to 1. Use this value N to substitute it in the formula of the alkane CnH2N plus 2. So we obtain here that the formula of the alkane is CH4 and application 3 is over. Hydrated salts are salts which are chemically associated with water molecules. Let's take the example of copper 2 sulfate. This copper 2 sulfate is a salt known by its blue color. In fact, copper 2 sulfate has a gray-white color. The blue color it shows comes upon binding to water molecules. As you see here in the picture, copper sulfate has a gray color. Upon adding water molecules, we obtain the blue copper sulfate. Now, how to represent the formula of this copper sulfate? CuSO4 anhydrous means without water molecule has gray-white color. CuSO4 will compare to water molecule having the blue color is represented as CuSO4.5H2O because it captures 5 water molecules. Now, how do we calculate the molar mass of a hydrated salt? As you observe, the formula of the hydrous and the anhydrous copper sulfate is different. So when we calculate the mass, we have to follow a certain rule. For the anhydrous, the molar mass is the molar mass of copper plus molar mass of sulfur plus 4 times molar mass of oxygen, which is equal to 160 gram per mole. While the molar mass of the hydrated copper sulfate is the molar mass of copper plus that of sulfur plus 4 times that of oxygen, and this dot here is represented as a plus 5 molar masses of H2O, where this molar mass of H2O is 18, so we obtain the molar mass is equal to 250 gram per mole. Now, a third application in this session is about dilution of a solution. It is required to prepare a solution S of concentration CF equals 0.2 mol per liter from an initial solution SI of CaCl2 of concentration Ci equal 2 moles per liter. Available glassware are beakers, volumetric pipettes, volumetric flasks, and graduated cylinders of different capacities. The question says, choose from the above list the convenient glassware with the appropriate volume to prepare with the highest precision the solution S and justify. According to dilution principle, number of moles of solute is conserved, so number of moles initial equal to number of moles final. But we know that number of moles is C times V, then C initial times V initial equal to C final times V final. Then if we take the ratio C initial divided by C final, it's equal to V final divided by V initial equal X, where X here is the dilution factor. Now the dilution factor is, if we substitute the value, is 2 over 0.2, it's equal to 10 times. But we then deduce that V final by V initial is equal to 10. But what is V final and V initial here? V final is the volume of the volumetric flask and V initial is the volume of the pipette. So choose the glass or the set of glassware that satisfies the value of dilution factor. Let's recall the materials available. The volumetric flasks are 100, 250, and 500 milliliter available glassware, and the volumetric pipettes available are 5, 10, and milliliter volume. If we choose the 100 milliliter volumetric flask, let's do the suitable calculation. 100 over Vi equal 10, then Vi is equal to 10 milliliter, the volume of the pipette. Now, if we look at the volumetric pipettes, we have a 10 milliliter pipette and we have a 100 milliliter volumetric flask. So the chosen materials will be a beaker containing the solvent water, a volumetric pipette of 10 milliliter capacity, and a volumetric flask of 100 milliliter capacity. Now the question is, what if we choose the 250 milliliter volumetric flask? You will do this calculation again and we obtain a 25 milliliter volumetric pipe. If we look at the materials given here, there is no 225 milliliter volumetric pipette. So the volumetric flask of capacity 250 milliliter is not suitable for this dilution. What if we choose the 500 milliliter volumetric flask? You will do the calculation again for a third time, and you obtain that the initial volume of the puppet will be 50 milliliter. Again, this 50 milliliter is not present in the suitable in the chosen materials or available materials, so the 500 milliliter volumetric flask is not suitable for this dilution, and as we see that the best volumetric flask to be used in this case is the 100 milliliter volumetric flask. Now, dear students, our lesson for today has come to an end. Your assignment is that you refer to the video and resolve applications 1 and 2 on the worksheet. It's worksheet 5, and solve questions 2, 4, and 5 from worksheet 5 in your chemistry book. Farewell, and meet you in a second lesson.